Hey you guys, today is post-op day 5. I should have blogged yesterday, but yesterday I was a train wreck. Well, today I'm another train wreck, okay? My mom is here only till Wednesday. Today is Tuesday. And she's been here since I think Saturday night, I don't know. But when I tell you, I am in pain, okay? I am out of, what's these called? Percocet, whatever. I'm out of those. And I've been taking the wrong Tylenol. I've been taking the Tylenol arthritis and joint. I've supposed to been taking the Tylenol muscle and pain. And my friend told me about some medicine that I can get over the counter at Walmart or Target, and it's on Amazon. It's called, what is it called? Neuracle, I think. I put it in the description at the bottom. But it's supposed to help me with stiffness and back pain, okay? I will go ahead and go over everything that my friends and family have been buying for me, and Amazoning me, and gifting me. It is such a blessing, because this stuff can become costly. Today, the massage lady here in Texas, she's supposed to be coming today, I think between 6 or 6:30. I gotta look back at the confirmation. It's one of them. But right now, I'm having on and off chills. My doctor said it, the nurse said that that's normal. But I do have some Aleve. Like I said, I'm stopping taking these Tylenol arthritis. Well, that shit ain't helping, okay? It only helped probably for like an hour. Oh, yeah. And then I have some antibiotics that I'm supposed to be taking 3 times a day. It looked like I only have enough probably just for 2 more days. Then I'll be done with that. My main concern is this drainage, okay? It is like in my way. It's already pulling my skin. I'm so ready to get it out of me. And yeah. I haven't even took a nap this morning because I've been in pain all morning. I'm trying to save that last Norco. I think it's Norco Percocet until tonight after I get out of my shower so I can at least sleep good tonight. But it's no air on. I have 2 thick blankets right here and I still kind of have the chills. This drainage ain't helping at all. Like it's in my way and it's pulling my skin. I'm ready for it to get out of me, okay? And I'm lucky because some people have 2 drains. I only have one. And they said when it started turning like yellow, like discoloration, it's not bloody anymore, that it's close to being time to be taken out at least 7 to 11 days. And I won't make 7 days until Wednesday. And on top of that, today, I'm getting a massage. When she massaged my whole body, she going to fill this jug up because I have a lot of fluid. Like, all right here, nothing but fluid. In my thighs, nothing but fluid, okay? I'm ready to get all that drained out. So, yeah, I'm getting ready to go warm me up some Campbell soup. It's low-sodium Campbell soup. I call myself trying to eat some smart popcorn yesterday. I don't care. That smart popcorn has salt in it. And it swelled me up even more. Like, I blew up like a high air balloon, okay? That salt is no joke. I'm staying away from salt. I don't want no salt. I'm done. I have some sugar-free popsicles. I have some fruit. I have some hydration packets that my friend bought me. She Amazoned me from Dallas. I can't. And I'm out of CBD. I don't have no more CBD. When I tell you that CBD had me right, that CBD had me right. So, yeah, I'm out of that, too. So, yeah, I'll keep you guys posted. I'll try to get my mom or my daughter to video record me getting some of my massages done today and some of the fluid taken out. But, yeah, I want you guys to follow my journey. Again, I had a tummy tuck with 4 areas of lipo on each side, muscle repair, and hernia repair. So, and today I finally went to the restroom on my own. I did not have to force myself. Like, I actually went on my own to the restroom to pee. I still haven't had a bowel movement. One of my surgery sisters told me it took her to the 7th day, and she took some drops or something. I gotta get that ordered off of Amazon. But, yeah. Tummy tuck is not for the weak. It's not. Them whores lied to me. Them whores told me, girl, you'll be okay. Girl, it ain't, girl, trust me. Lipo hurt more, girl. You gonna be just fine. After the 3rd day, you gonna be just fine. You whores, you lipo whores, you lied to me. 3rd day done passed. I'm on day 5. I still can't walk, okay? I'm still hurting. I can't even hardly hold the phone up because my arm hurting, okay? Everything hurting. It hurt to talk. I can't cough. I can't even laugh. If I cough and laugh, I'm crying, okay? I can't even, look. Your whore's alive. I'll be back. Keep y'all posted. Don't forget, do your research when you're looking for a good doctor. I'm not saying that I didn't have a good doctor. I love my doctor, but I'm just saying, always do your research for your doctor, for your post-op care. Post-op care is very important, okay? And it can get pricey. But, yeah. So, I'll keep you guys posted. Thank you so much for watching. Like, look at my nails. Like, my hair. She gonna get back together soon. But right now, I'm about to go put my robe on because I'm so cold. I'm not used to being without my robe, okay? But, I'll keep you guys posted later on. Bye. Good morning, you guys. I am back.
Oh my God.
I was supposed to check back in with you guys yesterday evening when a nurse came. She did come. I did an hour session and she made me get into my bod. Yeah. She said, no ma'am, no more binders. We're getting into this bod today, okay? So, she massaged me. When I tell you that my My drain was full, almost full, but she got through. I was so swollen, like extremely, extremely swollen. Today is day 6. And I have my faja on. I could tell like I'm drained a little bit overnight. But I'm in my bed. I slept on a lot of pillows. My faja gave me a lot of support. So yeah, I need to get up. This faja also come with a zipper where I can use the restroom. But when it's time to like do the number 2, FYI, TMI, I think I'm just going to take it all the way off because, But the number 1, I'm fine. I did get up in the middle of the night. I did use the restroom with this on. And, but see, this one only came with 2 buckles, like, only for you to go over. So I'm going to have to, once this one gets small, I'm going to have to go and get it taken in immediately because it didn't come with 3 brackets. It only came with 2 brackets. So, yeah. I'm going to insert a video of me with this on last night so you guys can see a full 360 dimension. And I'm about to get up because I feel stiff. So I need to get up and take some meds. Try to fix me something to eat, okay? And drink some pineapple juice. I will check back in with you guys later. Hey, you guys. I've literally been, like, sleeping all day. Taking my meds. I walked a little bit. Since I've been wearing my faja, my drain has really been showing out. Like, it's really been filling up, like halfway. My brother came by, brought me a salad from Chick-fil-A. I'm going to go ahead and eat my salad. I'm going to drink some cold water with it. I already took my antibiotics and my pain medicine. I'm going to use the restroom. I'm going to attempt to take a bath today. But I'm not going to get my incisions wet. So I'm going to sit on the end of the tub because my mom is not here to help me shower. So it's just me and my daughter. So I'm probably just going to sit on the end of the tub and take me a bath. And then put all this back on. Okay. But yeah, thank you guys for tuning in today. This was not a long vlog today, but I am feeling a little bit better. I'm just gonna say I feel better than yesterday. I had a new massage lady to come yesterday, and today I was kind of sore. I'm not gonna lie, like on the sides where she was massaging, she was trying to get all that fluid. Sore, okay, sore. So it is what it is. But I'm about to say my grace. I'm about to eat. Thank you for checking in on your girl on post-op day 6. I will see you all tomorrow. Thank you. Okay, hey you guys, I'm back. This is the ending of I think I said my last video was the end, but I just took my bath and stuff, and this is the end of day 6. I have on my white compression shirt that I ordered off of Amazon. I can leave the link below. It came with 3 pair, black, white, and pink. I'll be wearing the pink one probably tomorrow. And I re-put back on my stage 1 faja. I have my compression socks on. They're black as well. And I have some house shoes. Other than that, today I did get my order, a good friend ordered these for me, called Arnica 30C. And I will put the description of these at the bottom too. Today was my first time trying them. I heard they're really good after surgery and they're non-drowsy. And they're like little tablets. And you put them underneath your tongue and they dissolve like baby pills or whatever. Also, I ordered some Tylenol 8 muscle ache and pain. So I'm a little bit more flexible. Tomorrow on day 7, I make 1 week. I can tell my body is starting to get back to itself because now I can lean up and I can sit up like this with great posture without any assistance, as well as I can stand up a little bit longer without having to lean over and lean on something. So yeah, little progress, you know, but I'm still taking it slow. I'm taking it easy. I can tell that since I've been wearing my faja, a lot of fluid is going into my drain because last night was my first night sleeping in this faja on day 5. And I went to the restroom like 3 times in the middle of the night, literally. TMI, if I have to do the number 2, I try my best to like hold it to like late evening. I know that's bad, right? But seriously, I try to hold it because once I take this all off, I'll be ready to take a bath and then put it back on. And I don't want to have to take it all the way off just to do the number 2, then put it all the way back on. So I'd rather take it all the way off. Yeah, I'm weird, but hey, I don't want to mess up my faja. I don't care that it has a zipper down there. I pee through the zipper. That works fine. But number 2, no ma'am. Other than that, yeah, I'm kind of out of breath. I just took a bath. My daughter assisted me. I feel so much better. And I'm about to relax and hopefully doze off in a little bit, okay? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Press that notification bell. I have more coming your way. I do need to do some more videos talking about, the different medications that I was prescribed, how my stay was at the recovery house. I got all that good stuff coming. It's just right now, I'm tired and out of breath, okay? I feel like I'm still fat, but I'm not fat no more. But yeah, the swelling will be going down. It's continuously going down day by day. I'm just going to be patient with it. And I'm going to take it slow, okay? But other than that, thank you so much, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Hey, you guys. I am so tired, okay? Like, y'all won't believe what I did today. Y'all will not believe what I did today. Excuse my hair. You know a girl just got out of surgery. Look, okay? No nails, no hair, no edges, no baby hair, nothing. Period. But, yes, so I actually drove today. Today I made a week. I had to get some fresh air. And like after watching a lot of different people on YouTube that had the same type of procedure, was out and about after 2 weeks, I was like, let me get up and see if I can just at least go to a grocery store or something. So yeah, I got my steps in today. I went to like 3 places and got some air in my tire. Nothing major. My kids were with me, so I ain't have to pack nothing. And I did not get in a scooter car at the grocery store. I walked, okay? I'm so proud of myself. Even though I was tired, I was breathing hard. Oh, my God. It was so embarrassing, y'all. The drain was hanging. People was looking. Even in self-checkout, the man came over trying to help me. I was like, oh, my God. He's like, I don't want you to hurt yourself. I'm like, oh my God, it's so embarrassing. I look like a handicapped hippo. Oh my God. I just look like the type of person that, you know, you see sickly people like all the time. And I'm not sickly. It's just I had an elective surgery. So, of course, I'm walking slow. Then my drain hanging. And, oh Lord, it was just so embarrassing. It was just.
it was just so embarrassing. People was looking at me like, she knows she's supposed to be at home. But I don't know, I had good vibes today. Like, I was manifesting nothing but good energy and health and stuff like that, and prosperity. And I got up today and the little me inside of me was like, girl, get up. It's a mental thing. Get up out of this house. And I was like, oh my God, why did I listen to the little me inside of me? Oh Lord, have mercy. But yeah, I came home and I cooked for my kids. They was all looking amazed because I ain't cooked in like, because I was gone a week and then I came back. I've been back almost a week. Yeah, so. So yeah, tonight is going to be the first night that I actually bathe myself by myself without help from my mom or my daughter. Because my mom went back home yesterday. And my daughter, she's in the bed sleeping because she has summer camp in the morning. So yeah, I'm going to be in this restroom probably a little over an hour because I have to take my time. I don't want to fall or none of that. But I know for sure, Lord's willing, I'm going to sleep good tonight. I'm going to take my meds, put my compression socks on and everything and do what I need to do. And I'm going to lay it down because I know my body is tired. So yeah, I went on ahead and combined day 6 and 7. I don't know if this one is going to be 5, 6, or 7 or if it's just going to be 6 and 7. I don't know, but I'm gonna combine two of them for sure. And anyways, yeah, thank you guys for watching. I know I said it at the end of the last video, but I end up combining these. Okay, I'm on medication. Okay, prescribed medication. Okay, so anyways, it's your girl Crystal and I'm out.
We say to girls, you can have ambition, but not too much. You should aim to be successful, but not too successful. Otherwise, you will threaten the man.